Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question from Joe Wick, who asks, does anyone know how to rotate text in 2D? The rotate tool won't do it, and I don't know how to change the angle of the text so that it's, say, on a 15 degree slope. We're going to jump into that after the intro. Alright, so what Joe Wick may be using here is the text tool, and this is really sort of like it's a tool to annotate more so than to actually make text in 3D. So you can see that text is staying on my screen and it's also staying flat to my view no matter how I orbit. So that can be somewhat problematic if you want to actually like have something, you know, you're making a sign or something. You don't want to use the text tool, you want to use the 3D text tool. So that's what we're going to be using today, because I think that's actually what Joe Wick is trying to use. Again, for the text tool, that's more for annotating, for making call outs on things, something like square footage, stuff like that, where you're just calling out information, maybe room names, stuff like that. So 3D text is for modeling. So when you click that, it opens this little window that says place 3D text. You can type anything you want in here. I'm just gonna type sample text. A font, you can choose any font on your computer. I like this one, so let's choose that. Regular, if there are different kind of options for that font, let's say bold or italics, you'll be able to choose that here. Align, that's how you want the text aligned in the box that it'll make. I like center most of the time because I end up moving it anyway. Form, filled means that the shape will be filled in. It's basically like making a closed shape of your text. Extruded is the extrusion depth, and height is the height of your text. So if you have extruded, then I'll give you the depth there that'll unlock. So I'm just gonna do filled for now and put that in. So you can see I have some nice text. Depending on the text, it may not come in perfect. You may have to do a little bit of editing if you have your heart set on a particular font, because SketchUp doesn't understand every single font ever. And then if you want to rotate this, so let's say we want to rotate the text here at a slight angle this way. So we just want to, it's like this now, and we just want to rotate it up. So I would select this font, hit Q for rotate. I'm just going to press the up arrow key for a good measure. And then you can rotate it here. So if for some reason, let me move the default tray a little bit, dock it. If you wanted 15, you could just type 15 on your computer. It's actually not working. So you just go to 15 if your keyboard for whatever isn't working, like mine isn't. So that's at 15 degrees. Now if I want to do another one, I'll just undo that, Control Z. Let's move this down actually to the origin. So if we, for instance, wanted to rotate this up, we would do something similar. I'm just gonna hit the right arrow key and that'll lock to the red axis. And then I can rotate this up. Let's say we wanted this to be 15 degrees. We could do that. And then if you wanna extrude it at this point, you can do that. So I extruded here, and then you can just double click the rest of these if you wanna extrude the same height. And there you go. This could actually look pretty cool with a drop shadow or something. Let me turn shadows on from the right angle. Just mess with this a little bit. Yeah, so hopefully this helped figuring out 3D text or text and rotating it. If you have any questions about this or anything SketchUp related, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, please don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.